Hey guys, it's Shelby with Owlbeteen. Today we're doing a date night mommy makeover and I have Maddie with me. She's one of my really good friends and she is going to help me out with this video. You wanna go ahead and describe what we're doing?
Well, since our moms always get us ready, we thought it would be cool to get her mom ready for like a date night just because
we want to and it's gonna be fun. And it's just something that we like to do, so we're gonna combine forces. She's gonna do makeup and I'm going to do hair, and they're gonna combine like magic.
And since Becky is my other mom, I thought I would contribute by doing the makeup.
Yep.
Okay, so I'm gonna start by applying a BB cream, and this is by Maybelline. And then I'm going to go on the under eye circles and along the under of the nose with a concealer, and that's by CoverGirl. Then I'm going to set that all with a powder by Ulta. And then I'm going to go in with a blush by CoverGirl. And then I'm going to just contour and bronze with a nice little set by e.l.f. Okay. So I'm going to start with a primer, and I am just going to use a concealer, and this is the same one I used on her face earlier. And then to brighten up her eyes to start, I'm going to take the Tarte 9 to 5 palette, and I'll be using that a lot, and I'm using the light champagne color to go in her inner corners and on her brow bone. And then I'm going to take that same color and I'm going to put it on her whole lid. After that, I'm going to take the Next Step Up color, champagne color, and it's just put that on the outer half of your lid, and then blend it all together. And then I took this dark purple color, and her crease, and it's from the Tarte palette as well. And then I'm going to blend that all together. And then I'm going to take the e.l.f. Little Black Beauty Book, and there's a dark brown in that, and I'm going to put that in the crease over the purple. And then I'm going to take a vibrant purple from the same palette from e.l.f. I'm going to put that over the dark brown eyeshadow to bring the color back so it will pop. And then I'm going to take the medium champagne that I used earlier on the outer half, and I'm going to put that in the middle to bring back the shimmer and brightness. Okay, so I'm going to be taking this e.l.f. felt tip eyeliner to just draw where I want my line to go, and it's just going to be right along the upper lash line. And then I'm going to go in with a liquid liner by e.l.f. and I'm going to darken it up just so that we can see the line that we've created. Okay, and so after you do the eyeliner, I gave her the eyelash curler to curl her lashes, and that is by e.l.f. And then I took the CoverGirl Lash Blast Volume Mascara just to give her lashes some volume and length and darkness. Okay, so for the lips, I'm going to take this e.l.f. burgundy colored lip stain. In the package, it looks more purple, but when you put it on, it's really burgundy. And then I'm just going to put that all over the lip, kind of like a primer, but it gives the color that we want. And then I'm going to take this Hunger Games lipstick from the haul earlier in the year, and it is the orange side of it, and it has kind of a vibrant color. And then I'm going to take the other side of that in the middle of the lip to give it more shimmer and sparkle and brighten it more. And then I'm just going to take a clear gloss, any clear gloss that you have works, and that will just to make it shiny and ready for a date and for kisses.
Okay, we're going to do a Kate Middleton hairdo, and the first thing you're going to do is part your hair a little section behind the front and the part right behind your ear, and you're going to do that on both sides of the head. And then you're going to take about where your eyes and eyebrows are, you're going to begin a Dutch braid. So you're going to split in three sections, and when you grab your hair, you're going to put it underneath instead of over like a regular French braid. And try to stay close to the ear as possible. Her hair about the crown and the top of her head, and then just took the bottom and swept it up to the front. And what you're going to do is you're going to tease this section, and then I'm going to place it either in some bobby pins or a rubber band. Her braids, and what I'm gonna do, I decided that the Kate Middleton didn't work very well, so I'm just gonna do my own spin-off of this, and I'm gonna take her hair, all the bottom hair, and I'm gonna split it into three sections, and I'm going to braid it. And do your braid kind of tight, because we're going to put it into a braid, or a bun, so you want it to be tight. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of roll it into a little bun, like so. So that looks like a little flower, kind of, and then I'm going to pin it up. Use them to cover up your bobby pins. And now you're going to take your braids and you're just going to wrap them over on top of your bun, and kind of wrap them around your bun so that you can pin them up as well.
Yay! That was over in a second.